Hello, today we're looking at Antergos 18.10 and the Gnome Edition, which is default, and it's a very interesting edition of Antergos. It's not just, you know, all know Antergos is a rolling release. It is the latest of Arch and Linux code to offer, and it's always beautiful, it's always powerful, it's always fresh. But in this release, there's something even new. Newer than this. How can it be? First of all, there's a new installer. Or an update of the previous one. It's a beta. So, it is still... I struggled to install this operating system. Because it was all time throwing me out. It was all time an error. So I had to boot up in one of the safe modes of the CD live CDFs to offer. And I was finally able to install the system. But one thing which is very interesting, it gives us another option in the installation. That is to include a cache system. So it will make your internet overall quicker because you will have your own cache built into your system. So you will be able to store up the things you visit often. So you will be able to browse the internet. Browse things quicker than you had in the past, which is amazing. So that's fantastic. It's a step forward. They have to work on to get the installer from beta to stable again, that you don't have the bugs, but I'm sure it will be done in 18.11, maybe 18.12. So if you go to check the kernel version. Okay, I'm gonna open up the terminal and it is kernel 4.18.12 Arch edition, so that's really up to date. And if you go to desktop settings, like if you right click on your desktop, you get your normal GNOME default stock settings, which is just change the background, display settings, and system settings. And we're gonna open up the system settings. As you can see, for some reason, it's rather difficult to display it sometimes. And I realized it with the Xbox system of Ubuntu 18.10 also, that it's a bit slow this release. I don't know why, but I hope they will fix it soon. In Wayland it works just fine. So, as you can see, it's Antergos Linux. It's GNOME 3.30.1, so it's the latest GNOME. This is the first release of Antergos, which got like stock, as far as I'm aware of, which ships with GNOME 3.30. So, that is exciting, and if you look at some of the new GNOME power, you got your files, Nautilus, got a lot of love. It's much more clean and fresh at the top of the icons. It's much more put together to have a smoother experience. And the star files works much, much better also. So that is fantastic. That's a major improvement. I noticed in the past sometimes it doesn't want to work, but it's really working now well on Arch. It's fantastic. So also still no desktop icons. This file we just created is in your desktop folder, but doesn't appear on your system. That's one of the main reasons also why Ubuntu doesn't use files 3.30 yet. I'm comparing the two because they're both using the latest of GNOME 3.30, but Antergos takes it full on and they got everything. They got files 3.30, everything. Up to late, they said we trust the GNOME name, we do it where Ubuntu makes more a mix of the packages. So, it's interesting. And I like Antergos for the fact that you get the latest that is to offer. And as you can see, also the files view is also better in this later version. It's a bit stucky, as you can see. I don't really get why. But also notice in GNOME 3.30, so it's not just on terminals. Which is a bit of a concern, because we want all Linux systems to work fluently, but it also means that these guys behind GNOME is putting a lot of work in, and then bugs is gonna happen until it's fixed to make a better experience. You got an Arch repo, and KDE apps like KDE in Live, they sell at 18.8.1, and you get all the best of this GNOME also got to offer. You got Edge Top and GNOME System Monitor installed, and you can see how much RAM we are using, about 734. But what I found interesting, if we open up both, let's see if they both agree or not. This can be fun. Yes, that's what I don't understand. The memory which HTOP is showing is 856, where here we are already at 1.1 gigabyte of RAM, so who's right? I don't know. But it's interesting that they are not agreeing on how much memory they are using. But besides from that, it's a pretty clear straight up release of GNOME, and it works beautiful, and I'm really a big fan of this operating system, and I hope you enjoy this little run through. If you're on Terco's Arch, if you want to try out Arch, and if you're still like thinking what you will want to use and you want to try out Arch, on Terco's Manjaro, it is the glory of Arch. Manjaro is still filled with their own stuff, where on Terco's is more stock. You've got many desktop environments to choose from in the installation option. You get the peer-to-peer Arch experience with a very simple installation and easy to manage system, which is very cool. This is a great option for many people. So if you want to try it out, if you are not a pro, you know, to install Arch from scratch, build your own operating system, then Antergos is a great option. If you are running Antergos, just update your system. It's a great release. Thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.